Hello, everybody, and welcome to the DisGeek podcast. It's Minisode number 6, Disneyland news for the week of August 5th, 2019. Welcome to the show, everyone. I'm back. Took a little bit of a break from Minisode, just 1 week. I got back from Vegas and I was just super tired that day. We recorded a normal episode last week. I hope you enjoyed it. It was what would happen if Marvel took over Disneyland. We had some fun with that one. Hope you enjoyed it if you did listen to it. Let me know what you thought. I'd love to know. But for now, we're going to just do our little mini-sode like we do. Let's go on to the first story. So this past weekend, we saw the return of the Main Street Electrical Parade at Disneyland on Main Street, right where it belongs. I'm very happy that this show is back. I feel like it's kind of a it's kind of a marketing trick to get more people back in the park. And apparently it's working because from what I understand, the crowds are back. Back where they belong, right? So let's see. Like I said, I'm happy that the parade is back. I'm actually on record saying that I actually think this is a better parade than Paint the Night. Some people, I think, would have liked to have seen Paint the Night come back. But I'm glad it's this one. There's just something about this parade that Paint the Night does not have. This parade, in my opinion, has a lot more charm. The musical score is just memorable. I can sit here and think right now in my brain, I know what the Main Street Electrical Parade sounds like. I couldn't tell you what Paint the Night sounds like. I have no idea what the soundtrack is. I've seen it. I've seen it in video. I've seen it in person. And I've seen it a couple times. And I couldn't tell you what the music is. I know they put little bits of pieces of the Main Street Electrical Parade in there. But beyond that, I have no memory of it whatsoever. To me, that shows that it just doesn't have the staying power that the Main Street Electrical Parade has, in my opinion, of course. I think visually it's a much better parade, for sure. Better floats, better technology behind it. It's fascinating. Not saying at all it's a bad parade, because it's not. But I don't know, maybe it's because I'm an old guy. And I like the Main Street Electrical Parade. If you want to check it out, by the way, Disney Parks blog did their live stream. And it's on YouTube, and I'll have a link to it in the show notes. And you can check it out for yourself. If you've moved away like I did, it's great to watch. It's professionally done. The soundtrack's there. It's not, you know, you see these parades on YouTube, and, you know, YouTubers are out there, and they're pointing their cameras, and they're recording the Main Street Electrical Parade, and it's all good. But, you know, when they live stream it, they have multiple camera angles. They have dolly shots. They have crane shots. They're just, it looks really, really good. So it's very cool to see. So head on over to the our website, disgeek.com/mini6, and you'll be able to see a link to that parade. All right. Up next, I just found out about it. And I don't know what was going on. Maybe it was because I was in Las Vegas, or maybe it was because, I don't know, this story went by and I kind of ignored it. Halloween time at Disneyland. I feel like I ignored the story because I kind of, my eyes roll over when I see Halloween stuff in July. I'm just like, I'm not ready for it yet. And so I missed it, to be honest. But what they did is the Disney Parks blog put a story up talking about a little bit of more detail about a new show, The World of Color Villainous, which is going to be a new show debuting at the Oogie Boogie Bash. And now there's another thing I kind of like, my eyes sort of glazed over. I mean, Disney does so many, especially in Orlando, they do so many private parties that I thought this was just I heard of the Oogie Boogie Bash, but I just dismissed it as another like, oh, another one of these like dessert parties or whatever. Like I didn't know exactly what it was until I saw this story. I didn't realize that the Oogie Boogie Bash is basically Mickey's Halloween, whatever that party was. Mickey's Halloween. Oh, my God. I can't remember. Okay, it's Mickey's Not-So-Scary Halloween Party. I knew it was something like that. But anyway, this year at Disneyland, they are not doing that. They are doing the Oogie Boogie Bash. The Halloween party's there, and it's at California Adventure, which is awesome. When Mickey's Not So Scary was at DCA, I thought it was better. It was so well done over there. It was way more low key than it was at Disneyland. I think it's different now. I don't think it's going to be as chill as it was back in the day. But they're starting this on September 17th for 20 nights. And anyway, one of the shows that they're going to do with this thing is they're going to be doing World of Color Villainous. And the Disney Parks blog showed a couple of screenshots of what the parade's going to look. I mean, I'm sorry, what the show's going to look like, World of Color. And it looks really good. It has a cute little storyline about Oogie Boogie and a little girl named Shelly Marie, and she's trying to decide what costume she wants. And, you know, she wants to maybe dress up as some of her favorite Disney villains. And then, you know, they do this show, and she goes on a little journey and hangs out with the Queen and Ursula and Hades and Jafar and Maleficent. Speaking of Maleficent, side note, my daughter Marley, she just did a play, and it's called Enchanted Sleeping Beauty, and she basically played Maleficent. They called her Evelina, and my daughter destroyed it. Anyway, that's me being a proud papa for a second. She killed it, though. She was awesome. Anyway, back to Disneyland news. Sorry, I went proud papa for a second. Some of the other things they're going to be doing over at Disneyland for Halloween time, because, you know, the Halloween season is gonna show up, and you know how it is. It starts starts September 6th and is gonna last through Halloween, October 31st. And they're gonna be doing some of the same things that, you know, we know about. So, you know, the same old stuff. I mean, do I really want to read it all off? Over at Disney California Adventure, they have the Headless Horseman statue. They're also going to have the Headless Horseman kind of ride down Buena Vista Street at certain times. Cars Land is going to have the Halloween Festival. They're going to have Mater's Graveyard Jamboree, Luigi's Honking Halloween. Guardians of the Galaxy's Monster After Dark. That's actually the only one I've seen. Paradise Gardens area of DCA is also going to be home to the Plaza de la Familia, a Dia de los Muertos themed offering featuring food, entertainment, and activities. There. Sorry, I'm cracking myself up because I can't pronounce anything. Returning for a third year is a musical celebration of Coco. So that's pretty cool. And over at Disneyland, Jack Skellington's Haunted Mansion, you know, it's coming back, as it always does. Haunted Mansion Holidays coming back. They're not doing Space Mountain Ghost Galaxy this year, so that's kind of weird. They're going to continue doing the Hyperspace Mountain. I'm sure I'm missing things. Some of this I'm sort of going off memory. We're going to have the giant jack-o'-lantern on Main Street, of course. We're going to have that awesome... Uh-oh, here we go again. Dia de los Muertos display over in Frontierland. We're going to have that. Oh, and another thing that, from what I understand, is the fireworks show, Halloween Screams, that they do. They usually do that during Mickey's Not-So-Scary Halloween Party. But this year, they are going to, it says it's going to prevent a version of Halloween Screams most night during Halloween time. So that's awesome. So that show is going to be available for all guests. So good times, Halloween in August. Gotta love talking about it. But what's more fun than talking Halloween so early? That's right, everybody. It's time to talk about Christmas. It's coming. The holiday season is going to begin on November 8th. I'm kind of Christmased out already because, like, when I was in Las Vegas, my mom, all she watches is the Hallmark Channel, and it's Christmas in July on Hallmark. Talk about torture. But anyway, the holidays are going to be back as usual, and they're going to have, you know, the entertainment and the treats and the merchandise and the decor and all that cool stuff. DCA is going to move World of Color once again to World of Color Season of Light. So that's going to be cool. They're going to have Believe in Holiday Magic. They're going to have a Christmas Fantasy Parade. And of course, they're going to have It's a Small World Holiday. And also continuing on is Haunted Mansion Holiday. Good times had by all. Christmas. Talking about it now. Gotta make those plans. Oh, and that's it. There we go. Minisode. That's what it's all about. That'll do it, man. Thanks so much for listening to, once again, the DisGeek Podcast Minisode. It's disgeek.com/mini6 if you want to see those show notes, including that video to the live stream of the Main Street Electrical Parade. So if you want to see that. Also, we are on Instagram and Twitter, and you can find us over at DisGeek Podcast. And if you like what we're doing over here at the DisGeek Podcast, please consider helping the show by heading over to Patreon. Patreon.com/DisGeek. And that money goes to all of our various hosting costs that we have. We have hosting for our files. We have hosting for the website. I have to pay a monthly fee to edit the show because it's on Adobe. So you know how that is. If you do Adobe, I got to pay for that as well. So all that money goes towards those things. And that way the show can pay for itself instead of, you know, the money coming out of my own pocket, which I don't mind. I'm not complaining or anything, but, you know, it would be cool. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for listening. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.